my lord, we have seized this vagabond who's one of the usurper feline's dogs that must be dealt with.
Silence!
You are but an envoy and a merchant. Don't presume to counsel me on matters of state.
Know your place.
Oh, hi there. Yeah, today on the Garboard Herald, Root, the Clockwork expansion, because there's got to be a better way to play Root by ourselves.
The Root Clockwork expansion is a series of automated opponents originally born out of the fan-made Better Bot project. In it, you have player boards, cards, some number tokens, and rules for four complete and streamlined automated versions of the OG Root factions, replacing the unpredictable and rather lacking mechanical marquees included in Riverfolk. Each of these boards can be played in place of an opponent, allowing for solo, cooperative, or better filled out low player count competitive games. Want a full dynamic experience but in self-isolation? Play against two or three bots at once. You and your partner tired of only Eerie and Marquise matchups in two-player games? Stabilize your game by making one of those factions a bot and play lizards or corvids to your heart's content. Or just not in the mood for taking on your friends? Well, play cooperative, where all players have to manage to score 30 points before any bot makes it to their 30-point victory. Each bot comes with its own player board, conveniently listing the steps in clear and concise ways, and has cards for difficulty adjustment and additional traits that can be optionally included for a spicier game. The bots themselves are designed to mirror the thematic and mechanical impact of their player-controlled counterparts, while still being relatively easy to manage. Whereas the original Marquise had you arranging a series of cards for orders, and you used spies to replace dominance cards and made all sorts of decisions in unpredictable patterns, here they are aggressive and steady. Just draw a card. Yeah, for the most part, each bot just has you draw an order card, and based on the suit, the bot will take actions. The mechanical Marquise 2.0 recruits, establishes control, expands, and builds. The electric Eerie builds its decree, resolving campaigns for each card suit, venturing in massive troops toward areas to build roosts. The Woodland Alliance rapidly sends sympathy out among the board and then causes revolutions everywhere, creating bases which, with enough units on them, will convert into more sympathy, and the Vagabond hungrily gobbles up items from the board and players, resolving a sequence of actions and spending items regardless of type to move, quest, aid, fight, and resolve the special action on the selected one of three Vagabot roll cards.
There are other nice little conveniences that exist to simulate the experience of playing against a full opponent without having to fully resolve the action that it's associated with. Like, take for example, crafting, right? Well, when you draw an order card for a bot and it has one of the item tokens listed to craft, well, it will craft that item regardless of how many crafting spots would normally be available for the human player of that faction. It just takes that token and gets 1 point for it. Always. It's clean, elegant, simple. Also, just as bird cards are generally more powerful for human players because of their overall versatility, so too are they for bots, but in a different way. See, bird cards, when they are ordered, are a way of accelerating the general focus of each of the AI factions. The Eerie has a more flexible and therefore more consolidated force by the time they resolve their bird column. The WA gets to spread mad amounts of sympathy and revolt in the same turn, and then the Vagabond, well, they get to potentially gather multiple items to grow more powerful, then move on to battle. It's these touches that really round out the experience, and it's really impressive and kind of relieving that they were able to strike this level of balance where you feel like you are playing a full-on robust game of Root without having to be bogged down with a bunch of micromanagement and nuanced decisions. Though, that's not to say there isn't a degree of management.
One of the things to know about this expansion is that it's not as simple as just scattering some components out on the board and carrying out a basic action. These are surprisingly complex AIs, and you will have to make decisions based off of which clearing has highest or lowest priority order, helpfully marked by the 1 through 12 number tokens on the board, or which of all possible moves leads to most enemies or least enemies, which opponent to attack, how many units to leave. But for all that, it's surprisingly quick, intuitive, and has nice flow. The boards themselves impress the hell out of me because, just like the base game, as long as you follow the sequence, they are pretty thorough in capturing all you need to do. By only revealing one order card per turn to dictate their actions, you don't have too much to contend with, and the sequence of prioritizations is well thought out. Make no mistake though, as much as I like playing solo and enjoy beefing up my two-player games, I don't think these are true substitutes to the real deal. Root is as much a game of alliances and intrigue as it is sheer tactics, something that a bot can never really replace. Also, the cooperative mode is intriguing, but requires liberal amendments to make the bots work as a team or substantially increase their difficulty to give two reasonably skilled players a challenge, and as such, co-op is okay, but overall the weakest new option presented to you. Also, as admirably logical and streamlined as they are, the AI's execution wasn't perfect out of the gate. When I first played the game against the Marquise and Eerie at the same time, the Eerie started stumbling into a loop of returning to their own roosts. I checked and rechecked the rules, and sure enough, I was doing things correct. Apparently, some priorities weren't properly established in the printed version, and errata had to be swiftly released, which will be incorporated into future editions, but it is available online now. With it, the Eerie stomps happily around in fearful packs, appropriately questing towards vulnerable and unclaimed land to build their roosts.
So now that the Eerie are fixed, I love this expansion. I mean, I've always been a big fan of Root, but the two-player game always felt a little lackluster, and the solo was never really a meaningful experience. But suddenly, that problem is resolved. Probably my favorite way to play solo is with two AIs at the same time, which for me is the right level of balance for the feeling that you're getting a complete and robust strategic experience, but not getting too overwhelmed by all the complexity. And with each of the different AI factions, once I had played a couple turns with them, getting to master how to perform their turns really wasn't that difficult. Look, I've usually been one of those people who really don't like performing actions for an AI, especially if there are a lot of decisions to be made based on various game state variables. If this, then do this. If not, then do this. But this feels so well realized and, yeah, intuitive that it didn't really bother me much. Typically, two bot turns took about as long as one of mine, meaning that I was doing less robotic babysitting and getting into more of that good, meaty, strategic force critter goodness that makes Root so special. It allows for dynamic solo and low player count games, which makes more factions viable and provides a ton of really cool parameters to play around with through the number of bots you play with, the difficulty levels, and their traits, which provide so much tactical and thematic intrigue. So if you are a fan of Root and you have any love or interest whatsoever in solo games, or you just want to experience more of the factions but can only ever seem to get two or three people to the table, and you feel like you have a degree of patience for priority management of the automated players, then yeah, this expansion is so, so good, and it has made Root one of my favorite solo games, which couldn't have happened at a better time. All right, everyone, stay safe, stay home, stay healthy, and play tons of solo games. I want to hear all about your experiences, and thank you so much for watching The Cardboard Herald.
If you enjoyed this video, we have all kinds of other reviews, interviews, and recommendations via writing, podcasts, and video here on our channel and website, cardboardherald.com. Our content is audience supported, so if you want to show your support, please visit our Patreon. Thank you so much for watching. This has been The Cardboard Herald.